So looking at the past decade, we can say that in the European Union and its member states, climate change litigation concerned first almost exclusively very specific, often quite technical aspects of climate legislation, such as the European Emission Trading System and so on. The first strategic climate case challenging the overall objectives and performance of a state in terms of mitigation has been brought in 2013 in the Netherlands. I refer to the Urgenda case with a final decision by the Supreme Court of the Netherlands in December 2019, confirming the judgment of the Court of Appeal of The Hague that the state of the Netherlands acted illegally, contrary to the duty of diligence of Articles 2 and 8 of the European Convention on Human Rights by failing to make further reductions by the end of 2020 and confirming that the state should reduce emissions by at least 25%. Similar strategic cases are friends of the Irish environment, with a final decision by the Supreme Court of Ireland in July 2020, Grand Descent, with a final decision of the Supreme Administrative Court of France in July 2021, Notre Affaire à tous, with a final judgment of the Administrative Tribunal of Paris of last month, Neubauer et al., with a judgment of the Constitutional Court of Germany in April 2021, the Klimaatzaak, a judgment of the Court of First Instance in Brussels in June 2021, and a first important case on the overall performance of an oil multinational with Milieudefensie and Allies versus Royal Dutch Shell, a judgment of the District Court of The Hague in May 2021. Looking at this jurisprudence, we can discover some common general principles. The protection of life and health includes the protection against environmental pollution. Human rights constitute a positive obligation to protect against environmental harm, including the harm resulting from climate change. Emission cuts must not be postponed to later, when only an extremely short time is left for radical transformations. And to reduce emissions is obligatory, even if a state's shares in global emission is small. It will be crucial for Europe to see whether the European Court of Human Rights will endorse in the cases Duarte, Agostinho and others versus Portugal and 32 other states, and in the case Union of Swiss Senior Women for Climate Protection versus the Swiss Federal Council and others, the human rights approach taken by the Dutch Supreme Court or not. Its decision will, I have no doubt, influence judges in other parts of the world. But even when states, organizations and multinationals are adopting the necessary ambitious reduction programs, then will come the next hurdle: how to ascertain that all measures that are necessary to obtain the goals are taken and executed, and if that's not the case, which remedies are available for the judiciary, while respecting at the same time the separation of powers. It came indeed not as a surprise that at the end of 2020, the Netherlands did not meet the Urgenda reduction target of 25% at all. I think we will see more cases in which the implementation of more ambitious programs will be at stake and judges will be invited to decide on remedies for such situations. Furthermore, also in the best scenario, climate change is happening and will require important adaptation measures. I expect that these will give rise to another stream of cases, example given if private property will be claimed to construct dikes or other crop protection provisions, such as water reservoirs for drinking water or for irrigation and so on. And then we have the cases in which, as a consequence of climate change induced extreme weather events, serious harm has been done people lost their properties or their lives, as we have seen in July this year with the floods in Germany and Belgium and in other places around the world. Emergency responses by public authorities in such situations are being questioned. There are criminal investigations ongoing in Germany, checking if evacuation alerts have not been given too late, or in Belgium, inquiring if in the light of the weather forecast, the authorities should have started releasing more gradually in the days before the extreme rainfall occurred, water from upstream reservoirs to avoid tsunami-like events.